Apple started off a busy year of new products with the January announcement of the iPhone. Named Time Magazine's Gadget of the Year, Apple fans were teased when Steve Jobs introduced it on the stage at Macworld Expo. After only a few months more, they could have it in their hands. While users are looking for a few tweaks in iPhone 2.0, like the ability to capture video, use mobile iChat, or have push email, many of the complaints have centered around the slow 2.5G GSM network. In the meantime, iPhones can connect to Wi-Fi hotspots. Former US FCC Chairman Reed Hunt characterized the iPhone's slow network like the Ferrari being introduced to a country of dirt roads. Be on the lookout for 3G iPhones in 08.
I have an iPhone, and I had to switch to AT&T. Okay, that's wonderful. Well, I got my first AT&T bill. Right here. In a box. Let's see what's inside.
Justine's 300-page bill from AT&T listed every one of the up to 35,000 text messages she sends each month. She and others railed against the carrier for providing such detailed phone bills. Following the outcry, AT&T sent a text message to every iPhone, telling users they will receive a more simplified bill. And just when you thought Apple couldn't be more pervasive in your life, the company debuts Apple TV. Like the iPhone, it was also debuted at Macworld Expo in January. For $300, you can now sync and stream your iTunes content between a PC or Mac and your television. Available shortly after the release of Apple TV was the ability to watch YouTube content as well. Looking like an iPhone twin, the iPod Touch offers everything except the ability to call up your friend. Slightly slimmer than its phone counterpart, the Touch allows you to wirelessly download music from the iTunes Music Store. Though don't expect to download any iTunes videos, you can. But featuring Safari, you can experience a full version of the web. The 8GB Touch goes for $300, the 16GB, $400. But at $400, you might as well buy yourself an iPhone. Joining the Touch were also revamped models of the iPod Classic and iPod Nano. Long overdue for a facelift, the iMac debuted with a new look this summer. Apple's designers ditched the three-year-old white casing in favor of anodized aluminum. Inside the iMac are Intel Core 2 Duo processors that support up to 4 gigabytes of RAM. They also feature hard disk drives up to 1 terabyte. While Mac users enjoyed the new redesign, they found themselves searching for words they thought were reserved for PC users. Freezes and lockups forced Apple to distribute operating system fixes in November. With your new Mac, you of course need a new OS. Apple fanatics were out in full force for the first update to the Mac operating system in 2.5 years. The new version of the operating system offers Time Machine, an automatic backup system, Spaces, a way to create virtual monitors and flip between them, Quick Look, that allows users to preview documents without opening them, and other additions. At the San Francisco launch, diehard fans were there ready to defend Apple against street-taunting PC users.
Transparent menu bar and reflective dock.
Yeah, do you have a Zoom?
You know, Zoom comes from the word Zoom in French, which means your Zoom isn't as cool as my iPod!
Sorry about that.
And lastly, rounding out the year, October brought bad news from Greenpeace when they released a report citing that the iPhone could be dangerous to your health. The group found hazardous materials on both internal and external components of the phone. The tests revealed chemicals that are prohibited in children's toys in parts of the US and Europe, and in half the samples found compounds that would create a toxic gas if the iPhone were burned. Greenpeace questioned why Apple couldn't follow the lead of other handset manufacturers and use non-toxic materials. The group cited Nokia as already doing so. The negative news didn't curb enthusiasm for Apple products. Stock prices this year reflected general consumer content. In mid-December, the stock hovered around $200 a share, up about 110% from the same time last year. For the IDG News Service, I'm Nick Barber in Boston, with reporting from the IDG Network of Global Correspondents.